Everyone is saying you should use BigQuery with GA4, but you say, I don't know SQL. Well, there is no excuse anymore, because with ChatGPT, you have a trusted assistant that can help you out. Let me show you how. To run queries in BigQuery, we need to navigate its interface, which can look quite scary. But no worries, we'll quickly go through it in this video and look at the steps to get started with our project. If you're familiar with BigQuery, you can skip this part. To run queries, we need three things. First, a BigQuery sandbox account, so you can play with data for free. No credit card or billing required unless you decide to upgrade. Secondly, we need a project. And a project is a place to store our BigQuery data. Three, we need a dataset. Step one, make sure to use a Gmail account and in your search engine, search for Google Cloud Console. Then you can either click on the Google Cloud platform here or the Google Cloud Console Web Interface Admin. Alternatively, you can always use the following URL. Type console.cloud.google.com and you should land on the following page. And we're now prompted to, at a minimum, select our country and also agreeing to the term of services. If you're already an existing user, this is the page that you should see. You'll see the project that you're working on and also the different projects that you can access. But we'll create one from scratch. Now I've selected the country, we'll agree to the terms of services, fill in email updates, and then click on agree and continue. Now we're back to the homepage and we need to create our project. You can do this in different ways. You can select a project and create a new project, but I would like us to go to the BigQuery workspace. So select the navigation menu, scroll down and select BigQuery. And we are now in our SQL workspace. Let's create a project. We're going to rename our project. We also have the option to edit our project ID, but I'm satisfied with this name. Now let's click on create. And congratulations. We now have our BigQuery project in the sandbox account. What's left to do is to add our dataset, and there are multiple ways to access BigQuery's public datasets. To achieve this quickly, simply go to this page which has our BigQuery sample dataset for GA4. Click on the following link, which will lead you to the exact table with the data that we need to query. However, to do this within the SQL workspace, go to Type to Search and type Public. Press Enter. You'll find zero results. Now, click on Search All Projects, and what that will do is to broaden your search. We'll focus on the BigQuery public data. Now click on Show More. And now let's search for our GA4 obfuscated eSample dataset. Here it is. Now this is not where you have your actual data. So that you can understand quickly, this is a project. Within projects, you have datasets. And again, datasets is actually not where you have your data. Datasets will only give you info about your dataset. To find your actual data, you'll find it within your dataset. So if I was, for example, to click here, you'll now find a table. Click on events, and now we have here our GA4 data available to query. This is not mandatory, but a nice document to have is the GA4 BigQuery export schema. This will help you understand how GA4 data is structured within BigQuery, the names of the columns, and the data types. This way, you can know what's available and what you can use with ChatGPT to return the results that you want. Now, I know this is a free account, but we are still going to cover some best practices in order to avoid or limit costs when it comes to dealing with companies' data. First, go to Details in order to figure out the size of your dataset. And here we are dealing with megabytes, so we are still safe. If you're seeing gigabytes or more, just be prepared to pay some money. Glad that we got this out of the way. Now, let's go to ChatGPT to get this party started. Let's go to Details and let's copy our table ID. Perfect. Let's open a query in a new tab. I'll delete this. To give you an example, in SQL, when you want to retrieve everything, all the data available in a table, you can use the select statement followed by the asterisk. Here's an example. Type select, asterisk, which means everything, from. Now you can paste your table ID. Caution, before running your queries, always make sure to look at the message here on the right side. First, you have the green check mark, which lets you know that your query is valid, and most importantly, the following message, which lets you know if there are any costs involved. Because we are dealing with megabytes, we are still within the free tier. If you are seeing gigabytes or terabytes, you will then have to come here to your query and adjust it to fall back into the free tier. However, if you have no other choice than dealing with gigabytes or more, just make sure to always query only the data that you truly need. At this point, ChatGPT is extremely useful if you have limited knowledge of SQL or if you just want to simplify the query writing process. We'll delete this. And let me quickly say hi to my buddy here. Okay, ChatGPT, write me a SQL query to retrieve everything from this BigQuery table. paste your table ID. And we now have a response. Let's copy this code back to BigQuery. I'll paste this code. We have the green check mark and we can see that everything is correct. Now, let's click on run. And right here, under at the bottom, you can see the results of our query. Now let's crank it up a little. Let's say that I wanted to retrieve only the event date column and the event name column. I can copy this and just copy, or just go back to our GA4 export schema and do the same. In ChatGPT, I'll write retrieve these two columns, event date and event name. Back in BigQuery, let's paste this, and again we have the green check mark. Let's run this query, and we do have some results here. You can also click on expand, and now we only have the event date column and the event name column. All right, now in our results, we have all the rows available in our table. In fact, if you look at the results per page here at the bottom right, you'll see that we have close to 27,000 rows. In BigQuery, okay, this is not an issue because query costs are usually associated with the amounts of columns. Rows will cost you nothing. Still, I'm interested to see only the top 10 events, so the top 10 rows. Let's tell ChatGPT to show me only the first 10 rows. Copy the code. I'll just put this down. Let's delete this. Paste. And our query is valid. We'll run this. Let's check our results. And you can see that we only have 10 rows only. Back to our table preview. Let's have a look at the event name column, which stores different events occurring on our website, such as page view event or anytime a user scrolls on our website and many more. What if you were interested in looking only at the scroll event? I've opened a new chat in ChatGPT. I'll give it my table ID. Then I'll tell it that I'd like to select the event date column and also the event name column where the value is scroll. Let's give it a try. Let's open a new query. Let's run this code. And here we have only the scroll event. What if we're interested in looking at different date ranges or specific dates? Now, when it comes to dates, there is one slight modification that you must do. Always remove the date that is added to your table ID. And this is the format for dates. You can find it also in the details of your table right here. Replace your date with an asterisk. In ChatGPT, I'll just copy the code that we had earlier and repaste it. Let's remove the date here. And I'll tell ChatGPT that the dates for this code are between the 1st of December 2020 and the 1st of January 2021. Things become more tricky when dealing with nested or repeated fields. These are the most complex data types in BigQuery. Think of them as data within data. For example, GA4 is known to send what is called event parameters, which are additional data sent along with our events. Now, if you look at event params, we have on the mode repeated, meaning that we have repeated fields. If I was to click on the toggle, you'll now see different fields appearing. First, we have key, and key is a unique identifier which will be in a column, and that column will have the name of all our event parameters. If we look at the preview, you'll find it here. We have params, and then we have key as a unique identifier, and under that column, we have all our event parameters. Now, we can have different values for each of our keys, and this is why we have here this value that we can toggle, and we can have a string value, an integer value, float value, or double value. String value or integer value, the difference is that string can be text and integer can be number, and all of them will be stored in a different column. We can see them again in the preview, where we have, for example, here the string value and here integer value. So if you look at, let's say, the GA session number parameter, because it is not a string value and an integer value because it is a number, it will be stored right here. Whereas page location, which we expect to have a URL for the value of page location, since it is not an integer value, will have null, and instead it will be stored in the string value here. Now, I am interested to retrieve the page title, and now I'd like also to have the event name as a column and also the page title as a column. Let's see how to achieve this with ChatGPT. What I'll ask ChatGPT is to look in the following column and check for our page title. Then I'd like it to return the corresponding value of page title, which will be found in the following column. I'd like also to have event name as an additional column beside it. So in ChatGPT, I'll say get the event params name. So this right here, let's copy this and we'll paste it here. Column where the value is page title, along with the corresponding value found in the, and we'll select this column, because that's where the value is. Paste it. Typo here, all right. I'll also say, also return the event name column, which is this column. To make things more precise, we're gonna add only two notes. We're gonna put in our BigQuery table ID, which can be found in details. Come here and copy here. And we're also gonna precise that the event parameter have repeated fields. So going back to our schema, you can see event params has repeated for the mode. Event params is a repeated mode. Let's send this to ChatGPT. I find the code quite long. Let's ask it to simplify the code. Let's try this out. All right, let's run it. And now we have our event names and their page title. Some other rows. Sometimes we have the home page. Here you go. We come to the end of this video where we've seen how to use simple language with ChatGPT to return SQL queries that can be used in BigQuery. We've used Google Analytics for data, but this can apply to any dataset. If you're interested in GA4, we will cover a different tool in another video where you can achieve the same results just with clicks and without writing anything. If you found this useful, please like the video and share your thoughts with us. Anyway, this was Eric from Magic School, and see you next time.